Have you ever thought about the enormity of God? The sheer magnitude of His power and size. It's a tough concept to wrap your mind around because God is spirit, so there's nothing physical about His stature. He can't be measured by meters or miles, time or space. However, it might be possible to catch a glimpse of what we can't see or touch by taking an imaginary journey through His biggest creation. This spacecraft will transport us to the edge of the observable universe, an estimated distance of 270 billion trillion miles. We'll travel at the speed of light, more than 186,000 miles per second. At that velocity, we could make at least 600 complete orbits around the Earth in less time than it takes to eat a small bowl of popcorn. We depart on January 1st. Hurtling through space, we reach the moon in less than 1.3 seconds. Then 4.5 minutes later, we race past Mars. We continue on toward the gas giant planets, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. And just 5 hours, 20 minutes after leaving Earth, we reach the dwarf planet, Pluto. Now we'll adjust our flight path for an angle nearly perpendicular to the planetary orbits. Behind us, the boundaries of our cosmic neighborhood quickly vanish. We have entered interstellar space, the great void between our solar system and the next nearest star. A year passes, then two, three, 4 years. Finally, on April 19th of the fifth year since our departure from Earth, we are momentarily blinded by the light of the Alpha Centauri system. Three stars bound together by gravity. They are the closest stars to our sun. We have traveled nearly 26 trillion miles, but we're just getting started. 10 light years from Earth, 24 neighboring stars glimmer in our wake. One of them, Tau Ceti, resembles our sun. 100 light years, clouds of gas and dust in the Orion arm of the Milky Way surround us. 1,000 light years, the elegant spiral shape of our galaxy is clearly visible. Earth is located here. The Milky Way is part of a community of at least 40 galaxies drawn together by gravity to form what is known as the local group. For the rest of our journey, each point of light we see is no longer an individual star, but an entire galaxy filled with billions of stars. Our local group is adjacent to the Virgo Cluster, a massive concentration of an estimated 2,000 spiral, elliptical, and dwarf galaxies that emit searing clouds of plasma and dust. This spectacular creation is the heart of a chain of cosmic islands, once shaped by the gravitational pull of 40,000 different galaxies. Collectively, they form the Virgo Supercluster, one of the largest structures known to science. But as our view widens, this chain is quickly lost among countless formations of similar composition and size. For Virgo is a drop in a cosmic bucket that may contain as many as 10 million superclusters, each a slender thread in the large-scale construction of the observable universe. our journey has transported us 45 billion light years from Earth to the outer limits of scientific discovery. A sprawling web of filaments spun from perhaps 2 trillion galaxies and stars more numerous than grains of sand on all the deserts and beaches of the world. So how big is God? He's big enough to create a universe with dimensions so vast they are beyond our comprehension. Yet in the words of the prophet Isaiah, he can measure it all with the fingers of his hand. The magnitude of God's power and size can never be reckoned by mathematics or physics, for he is omnipotent, eternal, and infinite. But if we explore the cosmos with open minds, not limited to theories of blind chance and the random collision of atoms, we discover a magnificent tapestry crafted by a consummate artist who once spoke all of this into existence from absolutely nothing, then revealed glimpses of his identity through the grandeur and design of everything he had made. And for anyone who has ever looked into a clear night sky, evidence of God's stature and character shines brighter than the light from 1,000 stars.